Buffalo fans, I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup. Number 23 is a player who can handle playing under any pressure situation. He's a star player that we'll keep our eyes on tonight.
This kid provides the sparks of offense and defense for his squad, Brad. You can't find a more valuable player to his team.
The Hoosiers will clearly rely on him to make contributions on both ends of the floor. The Hoosiers should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Dick, as they're highly favored on paper. But what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. First of all, reward your big men for running the court. Get them some easy buckets in transition. Second, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. Finally, you got to pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store for us. Now they'll bring it up. Trying to feed inside. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
They look to get it to the inside. Taken away. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. They're working around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Entry pass in the paint. Tries for two. And in and out. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Dumps it in. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline. Trying to go inside.
Here's a drop step in the low block.
Very key is to get good post position, and he does, and then he drops the step.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Steals the pass. The point guard handles the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Makes the shot. On the outside. The fans are definitely making a difference here, Dick. This is what I call home court advantage. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. They move it into the front court. On the dribble, gives it up. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Gave it up. Looking for a good shot. Kicks it out. Number three fakes the shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Perfectly executed.
That's a 7-0 run.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Shoots.
Oh, you gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Meeks steps to the line for the first time. He misses the first shot. second one is good. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post-defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way. Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Hobbs receives the ball. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Takes the pass in the paint. Good job defensively. The shooting guard receives the pass for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. He gets the rejection. Stolen away. Top of the circle. Oh, yes. The skip pass is picked off. For the bucket. The layup. Hobbs is fired up and ready to go.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad. That's spacing.
They work the perimeter. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see raw man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. If I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with a deck. Where's he going?
Looking for a good shot. Intercepted.
Mr. Nessler, looks like there'll be an easy two here.
They are heating up this building where they're shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Lawson handles the feed.
There's the trap.
Stolen ball with a long bomb. They work it around the perimeter. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. They strip him of the basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Gave it up. Stolen away.
Look at speed. I'll tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
Indiana are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Oh. Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
And he's going to pick up the foul and all. Look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
He hits the second. He gets the ball. That's one of the things I absolutely love about college basketball, Dick, the atmosphere.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
Here's a lob, backdoor cut, easy bucket.
Yeah, nobody communicated on the back screen. There was no communication.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Stolen. Trying to draw some contact. He gets the bucket to fall. And the ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back to you.
All right, thanks, Aaron. From beyond the arc.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J.
Looking for a good shot. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. He fires from long range. Indiana have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. Both teams are looking to get something going here. A whistle and a foul. Coach not happy on the sideline. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all. Up and inside.
Picks off the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
It's crazy in here, Brad.
For the bucket. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Adam in the low block, but opted against it. From right at the circle. The Owls have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
Takes the pass in the paint. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Hit the replay button on that one.
He intercepts it. Defense got it after knocking it loose. Got it. He gets the foul and the bucket.
That's how you do it when you want to win, baby.
Hard. goes to the line for the first time. Nope. Got a nice screen. The shot from the baseline goes in. He draws a foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
And Nick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
West pounded on his way up. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
To the charity stripe. Makes the first. There's a reason they're called free throws. This team has got to be so frustrated. They are terrible at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Frustration only makes it worse, Brad. They have to figure out what they're doing wrong and fix it.
Tries for two.
I love the sky hook. He cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Low block. There they come with a double team to stop it. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from right of the circle. Great shot.
Part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Look at that student body. They are going mad.
Oh, yes, the student body. Always full of comedy and excitement.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Outside jumper. Working it around the perimeter. Three.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
They'll work it around the arc. On the dribble, gives it up. He pulls the trigger. Buried it.
Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy.
And he'll kick it back outside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Absolute mayhem. This place will be in disarray, Dick, if they can get a stop. Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call, though, by the official.
Gave it up in the paint. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He dials long distance. They're dialing threes up like nothing right now.
Hey, this is awesome to watch, baby. Basic.
They've left him completely alone. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes his first.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
He's got a high post flasher from three-point territory. Way off target. And he scores it off the glass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? And a momentary look from three-point land. The outside. He comes away with it. Here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Aaron's right about that, Dick.
I'll tell you, Aaron's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
The Hoosiers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
There's a double team waiting there with a deep shot from outside. There was no doubt about that one. Up fake. Tries to get the D to bite. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
You betcha. Opportunity for two for one. Big man spins down in the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other. Up and inside.
He takes the shot from the baseline.
Awesome job of running his guy into the screen to get off that gem.
Shot clock is dead. Goes for the deep one. He gets that one to fall. He shoots from the top of the key. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire. The first half sounds nothing as these teams remain deadlocked entering the second half.
allowed the ball to be taken away a lot in that first half, partner.
Not so much taken away, but given away. If you can't take care of the rock, you're not going to win many games.
Start of the second half, Dick, our focus player update. What's he got to get done in the second half for them to win?
I would run him off screens on the right and left. I would set up screens and have him pop out to shoot that trifecta.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Control of the ball. Takes it off him. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Gave it up. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The sky is the limit right now with the three balls, Dick.
Hey, defense better switch it up a little, or these kids will continue to light it up behind the arc.
On the inside, he unloads a three. That's good.
Great defensive play. Anticipating well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
They're on fire, Dick, from behind the arc.
I'd like to see how long they can keep this up. Got to take some pride on a defensive end.
How do you keep the man sealed on that double team, Dick?
Not like that, Brad. They really got to be active. Active hands, active feet.
On the outside, he uses the shot fake. He's going to muscle it on the end, and his shot rejected. Terry's modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
He's got to step out of it. His team needs him.
Two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Jumped in front to take it away. They're working around the arc. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
It's good. For the bucket, perfectly executed. Picks off the lazy pass. Jumps into the defender. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go. He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
On the dribble, gives it up. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Got to eliminate those turnovers.
You can't let a guy play with you like that.
Hey, he puts it in your face, take it away.
Gave it up, picked out of the air. goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I think a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
They're off into transition. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
That's eight unanswered.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Intercepted.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Got a man in high post. For the bucket, perfectly executed.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Leans in. He puts it in with contact and all. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Looking for a good shot. Way out on top, controlling the ball, sinks the shot.
That's a nice looking play right here.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. They work it around the perimeter. Picks off the pass. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
High post screen, gonna use it.
And he'll kick it back outside. Fakes a jumper. He shoots from the top of the key.
He got off the nice shot off the dribble by running the defender into that solid screen.
It's stolen. The ball goes out of play. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the players and coaches seem really confused around the bench area right now. Again, the focus seems to be getting their number one guy going. They haven't been able to do anything without him tonight.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Moving it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Takes it off him. They They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Looking for contact. Tickles a twine.
Look at that spacing. That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipated really well.
I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting it.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there.
The ball goes out of bounds. If his actions weren't deflating enough, how about this? He's definitely provoking this crowd.
Oh, Mr. Wrestler, that's a no-no.
On the outside. Here's a flash from the post up high. Puts up the tray. Gets it to fall.
Only the replay can do this justice.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. The Hoosiers are probably among the top schools in terms of basketball history.
They have a strong history, which is part of the reason why they attract talented players.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Almost lost the basketball. Unloads a three. Drains the shot. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Definitely a foul. Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Picked off. Now they work it around the perimeter for the bucket. Perfectly executed.
That's a 7-zip run. Great double team, really explosive.
He tries the three, gets it to go. Thinks about the shot. Pump fakes.
Double team now.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
And the ball goes out of play. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnover.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
Ziggy. Takes away the pass. He shoots from left of the circle. You betcha. He takes it away with a quarterback pass. Goes up for two. Up and in. Dribble, gives it up with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through and in and out. Drops the bucket despite the harm. leave it up. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. With a little baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Pull-up jumper from way out. Makes it. Picked off. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Basket falls despite the contact. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
They work it around the perimeter. Fakes the shot. Lobs it. Jumps in. And he scores despite the hack.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. On the dribble, gives it up. There's the fake. For the bucket.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
They're working around the perimeter. Launches away. That was nice. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Off the rim and no good. On the outside. Jumped in front to take it away. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
A high screen. He attempts the trifecta. Way off target. Nice shot.
That's why we have instant replay cameras.
On the outside, gave it up.
There's the trap.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Sweet, drains the tray. Barring some sort of miracle, I think this one could be over, Dick.
Yeah, I think this is over. It's time to get the guys in who don't play that much.
There they come with a double team to stop it. Tries one from three-point land. It's good.
Up and inside.
Trying to draw the foul.
He kept his dribble and ran the defender right off the screen for a beautiful jump shot, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
post, but elected to reverse the ball. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Again, a little one-man backcourt pressure. And the ball goes out of bounds. What a play. These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
Hey, Brad, the kids are fired up and having a lot of fun.
Here's a double team.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. 10 seconds to get it off. They work the perimeter. The ball goes out of play. Dick, let's take a look right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while, you'll get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
And yet another foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And, Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this point of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Number 24 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Second one is good. They call for a TO, Dick.
Hey, time is their worst enemy at this point, Brad. They're going to have to bear down and get some stops, then convert at the other end.
Player's got a much-needed breather with that timeout. Dick, is 10 points safe at this point?
Are you kidding me? 10 scratches wouldn't be safe with a half of this time left.
For the bucket, Dick, he's simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Hits his second. Robs him of the ball. Gave it up. Intercepted. Let's it fly. Off the rim and no good. for the bucket. Perfectly executed. Pushes it up.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the three. He gets the shot to fall. Cross court.
Dick, we look back at our focus player, and he was the focus of the defense, I think, too, because he wasn't himself tonight.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. It's so essential for the star player to really respond. He didn't respond at all in a positive way, and it affected his teammates as well.
Indiana fought the good fight, but they still come up short.
This is going to be hard to swallow since they were the favorites coming into this game.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.